You ever have a classroom rat?
No.
I have, because they stink.
Yeah.
Smell like shit.
They fucking, they do.
Wait, get a poop, classroom rabbit?
And their poop is round circles like deer.
Yeah, it's the worst.
So a lot of people have this. An animal that poops out little round circles, piece of shit animal.
Get a ferret, much cooler.
Ferrets stink.
We still have flying saucers.
You didn't get
saucers.
A lot of backup on that one, did you?
Only some classes had the cool animals and the rabbits. I wasn't actually in that class, but I do know that it was a pretty common thing in elementary school.
Huh.
Yeah. So what just happened?
Zito asked, because Nick brought up that he had a rabbit in his class, correct?
No, I did.
No,
oh, you did, yeah.
Wait, listen.
And I also doubled down saying, yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about. And Zito was confused that we had rabbits in our classes growing up.
Well, see, you probably had fucking vermis. Gerbils in a
you
ball.
Never,
no, we never had animals.
Did you read them?
You never had animals? You never had a classroom pets?
Oh, jeez.
No.
You know the common problem.
Inner city Chicago, you don't really have like animals in your room.
The common problem of mice and
maybe
men
that's the problem.
Is
why he couldn't.
What would be the problem?
Oh, why
pet couldn't?
Lenny, look at the rabbits.
Oh, so you're saying Zeke couldn't have? Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he's Lenny.
Are you calling? Oh, jeez.
I wish I was strong as Lenny. I'll be fucking lifting shit up left and right, bro. That's true. I love Mice to Men.
From Mice to Men.
Nothing like Mice to Men.
Mice to Men. ABC. Yeah.
I love a few good Mice to Men.
Mice to Men. Back again.
Wait, so you guys had no classroom pets?
No.
Not even a turtle?
No. Why would we have animals in our room?
Because they...
To learn, dude.
We dissected like an octopus.
That didn't happen. Yeah.
In elementary school?
Were you making calamari for the fucking sushi restaurant next door?
Yeah, that was my culinary school I went to.
There, we did have a sixth grade teacher who had a couple like pet rats, and she would just let those fucking things like crawl all over her, like gnawing on her nipples and shit.
Really? I like that.
That's
like,
absurd.
They would literally just like run around on her shoulders and shit. It's like, what the hell are you doing? Are you like fucking Willard? Get out. Like, put those fucking things back.
Something else. I'd rather a snake than three
much
rats.
Rather.
Rats, Jesus. Believe me, rats are an acquired taste as a pet. It takes a while to get over wanting to, like, I just want to fucking get rid of
fucking
this
smash thing. It with a baseball.
Yeah, exactly.
We had a fifth grade teacher who, not at the school, but at her house, had orangutans.
Oh, like, really?
Your fifth grade teacher did not have an orangutan in her house.
Yeah, she had a 600-pound orangutan living in her
silverback gorilla as well, I believe.
She might have like a capuchin monkey. She didn't have an orangutan.
Ask fucking Pat, dude. Ask one if Pat goes in here.
I've heard the story before. I know it's not an orangutan.
Yeah, it fucking tore her back apart. Dude,
Oh, no.
So she just let this thing walk around unhinged, like doing what he wanted.
Yeah. Dude, you would drive by the house and it would have fucking fence on the window. So like he couldn't get out. He's not lying. I'm not fucking lying. You can't do it. Won't do it. Here it comes right now to back up my fucking.
Mrs.
Yeah, Mrs. Brooke.
Yeah, it was not an orangutan.
It was an orangutan.
No way.
Fucking and that tore thing back
turned
up
on her. By the way, she missed school. Long time. I don't think she ever came back.
No. Did she die?
Well, just ripped her back apart. Dude, the spine was hanging out.
And she lived?
No. Yeah. Yeah. So she always talked about this pet too. Like it was awesome. You know, Mrs. Brooke was stern. Very, very stern teacher. By the
fair
way.
Fair.
Yeah. Oh, Mrs. Brooke wasn't the name of the orangutan.
No.
I forget the name of the orangutan.
I don't know.
This was the lady.
There's no way.
That got caught up in me selling cigarettes, by the way. This is a fifth grade teacher. Geez. Yeah, so very stern.
She was older.
Yeah, she was not thrilled.
Oh, by
they
the book.
Pulled a carton of cigarettes out of my backpack that was in the back of her room in fifth grade. But anyways, she talked about this monkey being her pet as if it was her best friend.
Yes.
And then all of a sudden one day, she stopped coming. And everybody was like, what happened? They're like, rumors were escalating. Like, well, her best friend turned on her. You know?
Oh, jeez.
What'd she say? I wonder.
It was a rank. I never heard from her again.
Well, she probably tried to discipline it, and you don't discipline a fucking orangutan.
Well, yeah, I remember Laurent Landry, I heard a story from him about his pet, Gucci, who was from the Dumb and Dumber, Pet Detective.
Yeah, that's what I thought you were talking about. Like I didn't even know it was legal to keep an orangutan domestic.
He had a zoo, I think, zoo license.
We're talking about 1999, I mean.
Yeah, that doesn't matter.
Things are easier to get away. There's definitely new rules today versus 20 years ago.
But easy to get away.
Not when it comes to orangutans. In captivity.
I don't know. I do believe it was orangutan. And what Dick said, there was just like cages on the windows.
Oh,
just
in case. I've seen the cage windows.
Like,
she lived on New Texas.
Yeah.
Good for her.
Good road. It's a good road in Plumborough. You just learned about a good road in Plumborough. New Texas is a good road. Hey,
you know, there's a lot of diversity in New Texas, by the way. You'll be out in the middle of a farm at one point. Then there's army housing that you pass at one point. Then it's one of the steepest hills you've ever seen in your life. And then you pop out of the school at some time. So, I mean, wow. That road... maybe the most diverse road in the history of
no roads. Wonder all you guys from that side of town were all fucked up growing up.
Whoa. What are you talking about?
All Holiday Park kids. You guys were all smoking.
Witnessing an orangutan beat your teacher to death inside her house.
Hey, we played no games over there. The HPTs reign supreme. Everybody knows the Holiday Park thugs were nothing to fuck with. Ain't that right, Nick?
Yeah, 1,000% right. 1,000%. You fucking dirtballs over in Renton or wherever the fuck you
are. Oh, Regency. But we sold cigarettes over there. Okay, we had pet orangutans. All right, we played outdoor... basketball was outside over there at Boyce Park. That's what we did in Holiday.
Made your own rules.
Yeah. We're Mavericks. We're the Maverick Mustangs.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Yeah.
Listen,
hell yeah.
We might have been poor, but we were at least respectful to society and we just didn't denigrate it.
I'm not 100% sure you're poorer than Holiday Park. We got some bad.
You never know. You never know.
Brighton is. I mean, it's right down the road from where we're...
Oh, it's a steel town.
There is a there's an actual steel mill that was on fire. That was, like, underneath the town that's in our area. Jesus. Like, fires have started in the mill.
Oh, yeah, one of the mines.
Be
yeah.
careful.
Yeah, it was bad. That's Plum, though. Hey, yeah, that's Plum, though.
Our parents used to, hey, be careful walking in the woods. You don't want to fall in a collapsed mine.
And they are on fire right now, so remember that. I mean, it's... Ugh. Plum's a wild place.
That's Pittsburgh, baby.
I was looking for the official orangutan law.
I'll take your word for it. You both seem very adamant about it. I apologize. Well, yeah, I didn't think it was possible to keep an orangutan in a domestic.
By the way,
who knew?
Rest in peace to Mrs. Brooke.
Oh, is she dead? Killed her for sure.
No.
Probably ate her fucking dead body too after he was done with it.
She was a good teacher. She does not deserve what you said.
Sorry, Mrs. Brooke.